Up next, we look at the new Microsoft Loop app. I'll show how it gives you a central place to bring people together to create real-time content in a simple, collaborative, and structured way. From using intelligent search to build your first shared workspaces where you can enjoy super fast, synchronized collaboration, to leveraging AI with Copilot and Loop to generate ideas with others on your team to get in your flow. Now, if you're using Loop components today, you'll be familiar with how you can embed live, auto-updating content seamlessly across your apps, like Microsoft Teams, Outlook email, and Word, all from the same source, freeing you up to work in your preferred collaboration modality, even if you take a break from working on the content as others on your team work asynchronously. Whenever you return to the component, as you can see here, where I've chosen to work in Outlook, the content is always fresh, it's live, and always up to date. This avoids wasted time linking out to other apps, jumping in and out of experiences, giving you a more fluid way to work. In fact, under the covers, the experience is all made possible by Microsoft's Fluid Framework, making the experience connected and interactive across your favorite apps, so you can work from wherever you want to, including the new Microsoft Loop app, in real time and at scale. And speaking of the new Loop app, co-creation with others gets even better. Not only does it give you a way to view and organize all of your Loop activity, it's also a full experience itself as a new collaborative canvas. First, let me walk you through how to get started. You can find the app at loop.microsoft.com, or you can install the Loop mobile app on your iOS or Android device, following the directions where the QR code on the screen links you. From there, you can use your work or school account, or a personal Microsoft account to sign in. And if you connect your Microsoft account to it, this also works using Gmail. In this case, we'll use a work or school account, which is tied to my organization. To get started, you'll create a new workspace by clicking the plus sign. This is a shared space where you can collaborate with your team. You just need to give it a name. I'll call mine Contoso Mark 8. The intelligence powering this is offered up related content that I have access to. I can optionally add keywords for even more content, but what I see here already looks good, so I'll select these two PowerPoint presentations. I can also choose to invite the team now, but in that case, I'll do this once I'm a little further along in the content. And now I just need to hit create. Within each workspace are pages. You can see that based on my content selection, Loop already has added a few links generated from the content I chose before, so I'm up and running fast. And within this untitled page, you can make it your own by adding a cover image, an icon, a name for the page, and then the content you want. I'll leave these blank for now, because to get started quickly, you can use page templates for the most common page types, as you'll see here for a project brief, a team decision, project home, meeting notes, and you'll see us add even more templates over time. I'll choose Team Decision as a good template for brainstorming, and you'll see it added the name and emoji, plus some areas for stakeholders, questions, background context, constraints, assumptions, ideas, and next steps. So as you saw, this gives you a great starting point to fill in your own personalized content based on what you were working on. And in a moment, I'll show you how this process gets even better with AI using Copilot. Let's move forward in time, where I've been adding structure and ideas for brainstorming before I share this with my team. Once I'm ready to share this page or workspace with my team, I just need to hit the share button above and choose the option I want. I can share the whole workspace so that the team can work on everything in the workspace together. Or I can share an individual page, which is great for pinpointing access. Or I can share this as a Loop component so that I can embed it in other apps, which I'll show you in a moment. First, I'll choose the workspace option and add Adele, Megan, Patty, and Alex. And once I hit invite, they'll receive a notification and I'll get access to this entire Loop workspace. Now let's get back into the sharing menu and go a bit deeper on that Loop component option. It will create a sharing link where you can control who can access it in your organization. Now from there, you can send people the link to get to this page in the workspace, but what's even more powerful is sharing this as a live Loop component. This is something you can do now with a work or school account within your organization and will come later to personal Microsoft accounts. Next, I'll head over to Microsoft Teams and use the link I created and paste it into a team chat. You'll see all of the content that was sent is editable here for my team members. And I can do things like add this as a loop component to a Word document and share that with people outside of my project team. You can add it to an Outlook email message directly so that recipients can edit it right from their inbox without even needing to hit reply. Now let me show you what happens when we all start working on this component. What you're seeing right now on the screen are four different members on the team, including me, all on separate devices using four different apps. Adele is using our Loop app in dark mode. I'm in Microsoft Teams. Patty is using Word and Megan is in Outlook. Everybody is simultaneously making live edits against my Loop component. Here we're all nominating our favorite influencers to help promote our new Mark 8 quadcopter. Alex on the Loop mobile app that you're seeing now is contributing directly to this page. And you'll see it's really easy to quickly add photos and interact with the content. And as each person makes an edit, everyone else on their device and using their app of choice sees the edit instantly. So as you saw, with Microsoft Loop, you and your team can co-author and create from within your app of choice, so you don't have to navigate to another app that only provides a single view of your project content. Now that you've seen how Loop works for collaboration, let me walk you through the controls you'll use and AI integrated capabilities that can help you create content faster. Back in the Loop home experience, some time has passed, and I can see all of the workspaces I've been working on, along with some favorites. And you'll notice that with the presence indicator, I can see that Megan is already in the Contoso Mark 8 workspace. I'll open up that workspace again to join Megan and hit the plus sign on the left. Here I can add a new page or a link. I'll choose a page. Next, I'll give it a name. In this case, I'll just add an icon without a cover image. And here I can type or insert content using the forward slash. And you'll see all the formatting options that I'll show you in a second. But now I want to show you how AI can help you get started and in your flow quickly. So I'll select Copilot. That gives me a few options to generate a starting point or pick a starter prompt. And these buttons give you sample prompts to create, brainstorm, blueprint, or describe what you want. In my case, I want to get started describing our Mark 8 quadcopter. So I'll type, describe the best way to highlight ease of use when operating a quadcopter. And it generates a nice list of items based on public information it knows about quadcopters. And I can see Megan is already in this page. And the great thing about Loop is that you can work with others on your team to refine the prompts together in real time. Megan has just added a prompt to change the tone and the format of the text that we've generated to sound more like it would to describe a quadcopter to a customer. But I think we can simplify that a little more and format this back into a bulleted list. And now we've got a nice starting point. Next, I can use the at symbol to notify the best person on our team, Adele, to match these bullets to the Mark 8's qualities. I have a few more ideas for using Copilot, but first let me show you a few of the simple formatting controls in the Loop app. I'll paste some text I've been working on to describe the Mark 8's audio features. And once I select the text, it brings up a menu to easily make it a heading. Now I'll select this section here and right-click to change its format to a bulleted list. But still, I think we can do better because the list of audio features sounds pretty technical with lots of specialized terms. So let's use Copilot to help make our audio description easier to understand. I'll go back to Copilot. Now I'll type, simplify this text description so anyone can understand it. And the text is still in my clipboard, so I'll paste it in. And Copilot has generated a much simpler summary of the audio capabilities. It's descriptive, but all the jargon is gone. So now it's looking pretty close, but I want more feedback. So I'll use this comment icon where I can easily add an emoji or text-based comment. And I'll go ahead and ask Megan what she thinks. In fact, commenting is a great way to collaborate with others without overwriting someone else's work. And by the way, if your content is somehow deleted or overwritten by someone else, version history is also available to restore to a previous version. And while you're in the workspace, let me point out a few more things that let you easily navigate to what you've been working on. Built-in notifications help you stay on top of everything and the changes that you need to know about right from here. Also, if you're looking for Loop components that you have access to, whether you created them or they were created by someone else, they're here under Recent, where you'll see their details. And while I walked you through the steps to create workspaces and pages, the Loop app is also great for capturing your ideas. When you have an idea, you can easily create a standalone loop page. In fact, you can see a few here that I've started. This is very useful to structure your thoughts before you share your ideas or add them to a workspace later, allowing others to join in so that you can watch your ideas build and grow. So that was a quick tour of the Microsoft Loop app, now in preview. It's the newest co-creation app for real-time synchronized collaboration across your favorite app experiences and devices. Try it out now at loop.microsoft.com. If you don't see this enabled for your work account, it will need to be enabled in the Admin Center. And if you haven't already, start using Loop components in Microsoft Teams Chat, Outlook, Word for the Web, as well as Whiteboard. There's more in store too, so make sure you stay in the loop on future updates on Microsoft Mechanics. Thanks for watching.